The goal is to be able to assess the history of knee injuries, which is critical for us to understand periodization on how to write the ideal programs for them, especially the first phase, the general preparatory phase, when we start to develop a program for them. We want to identify where they've injured themselves, whether it's current or in the past. A lot of clients, when they injured themselves in the past, they forget about it because then it's not hurting right now. Now that could lead to a range of compensation mechanisms that we need to identify. So get them to circle in this particular chart or sheet where they have injured themselves, whether it's current or the past, gives us an idea. From there, we want to identify areas of pain. Where is it in their body that they're hurting right now? That's where you want to identify as well. Okay, have they injured themselves recently? And then we move on to identifying whether the pain is there when they are moving or the pain is there when they are static. And that makes a difference, yeah? Because you understand that, let's say, a client can have pain when they are moving their shoulders right up to there, they go, oh, that's painful, and there's no pain right there. Or a client can completely go, I cannot move my hand because it's so painful. Or the pain is a pain that is there throughout the whole day, I can still move it, but it's hurting. This allows us to understand what sort of pain there actually is. It moves on to the next question, right? So on a scale of 0 to 10, describe the pain. So we understand where is the pain. It gives us an objective measure for a client to say, now this is your pain. Let's say your pain is 9 out of 10. And we create a program for you to help with this pain, to maximize, to minimize muscular imbalances over time. What is the pain after 8 weeks? We want to bring it down to a 0 or a 1, right? But essentially what we look at that, and look at that as well, is the pain a dull ache through the day? Is the pain a sharp pain that is a nerve pain? Is it a referral pain? Does it refer from one muscle to another? This allows us to identify as well, is it more of an impingement? That means the nerve is being pinched between the muscles or body structures? Or is it just a muscular problem where there is tightness in the muscles, there is adhesions in the muscles that we need to look at? This gives us a lot of clues even before we put the client through our dynamic testing. Now remember, we first screen the client from a static posture and then we put a client in a dynamic posture to compare the both. And I'm going to take you through the range of exercises we do that. Once we take the clients through a dynamic movement, and when we pair this, we are then able to identify what the client knows about themselves and what the client doesn't know about themselves. Do you understand what I mean? Because we all come to the gym thinking there is an issue with us. We've got our issues here and here. But our issue could be caused by a car accident that has happened 15 years ago that has also affected a range of other parts of our body. Those parts may not have healed properly, but they don't hurt. And because they don't hurt, you don't realize those are affected areas. We only identify the areas that are in pain right now. But when you take them through a dynamic sort of exercise, and understand their dynamic posture, all of a sudden you realize that there are imbalances in their body that lead back to their car accident they had 15 years ago. So what you are trying to solve is the root of the problem, not what is happening right now. Because like we said before, pain in their shoulders or their knees could completely be caused by cervical issues, but your neck being thrown forward from that accident that is not being sorted out. Weakness in another shoulder could actually cause ankle pain, or ankle pain could cause weakness in the shoulder. The body works as one, and often we only identify a particular area without assessing the rest. Okay, so these are tools to give you an idea of an overall assessment that's going to be extremely important to create optimal programs for your clients.